On this note, I've just minimized my chat box. And as I said, that what comes to your mind, what actually rings in your mind when you see this picture, I received a few interesting answers, self-perception, self-confidence, and you can be who you believe you are. Great. I'm rather presenting this picture in the light of self-awareness. I'm presenting this picture from the perspective of you being self-aware of yourself. So as most of the answers were on the first part, that I am all powerful, I'm all resourceful, and that I can do what a lion can. That means somebody who I'm trying to see, I'm seeing myself as, I can do what that person can do. This is effective only if you truly can. This is effective only if you truly can. Otherwise, it is ineffective and a myth if you cannot. So yes, in most of the motivational lectures, this picture has come up in most of the memes, in most of those presentations, etc., wherein the need was to encourage you, wherein the need was to say, hey, gung ho, yes, you can do what you want to do. Believe in yourself. Keep moving, keep moving, keep moving. I am trying to bring your attention to yet another aspect that can be studied and understood from a very, very simple, very, very frequently used picture, that is a cat looking into the mirror and seeing herself as a bigger animal. And yes, we also do it. But my question at this point is, if I am who I am, but when I think of myself in the self-concept, I think of me as a bigger me. I think of me as a more powerful me. I think of me as a more resourceful me. My underlining word is more. Then what happens? Anyone? I'll repeat my question. My question is very simple. I am who I am, but when I see myself, or when I'm visualizing myself, when I'm trying to gain that confidence, what I do is I see myself as more powerful than who I am. I see myself as more resourceful than what resources I have. I see myself as more equipped than as much equipped I am. What happens? Kinesthetic. Start feeling. What happens then? Any answers? Do I have it in chat box? Real and ideal self. I'm not sure whether this was for this question or was it for the picture. Anyways, anyone who would like to unmute yourself and talk about it. The underlining word is more, which means my self-awareness somewhere is not in alignment with what actually it is. Yeah. So I see a reply here. Let me see. I may be disconnected from reality. Thank you, Shrikanji. Fantastic. I was expecting something like this from you. Anita says, I may flounder. Oh, yes, of course. Beautiful word used there. Beautiful word used there. Yes, it may happen. In fact, chances are high and bright that if I do not accept the reality, if I do not accept that what is my reality and what is my potential, it becomes a gap area for me. And if I do not accept that gap area, I will not be able to influence either myself or someone else. I have a very interesting anecdote to share. Rather, I have a very interesting scenario to share. Most of us must be facing this scenario day in and day out. And that scenario is, you are a person who you are. So let's say Vipul is Vipul as he is and who he is. He is leading his life the way he is. And there is somebody in his life, maybe at personal front or professional front, as in neighborhood, relative, friend, family, boss, peer, anybody with whom he has to interact. But this person, by and large, puts Vipul off. By the expressions that this person is using, or by the way he or she behaves with Vipul, explicitly, implicitly, whatever. Huh? I'm sure you are able to put yourself in that space, imagining yourself as who you are. So you don't really have to imagine, and bring to your attention that person who you have to interact with, but that person has that potential. The person does it very frequently. What he does or she does, he or she puts you off. Are you able to visualize that? If yes, give me a thumbs up through the reaction button so that I proceed further. Great. My question is again very simple, because life is beautiful when it is simple. My question is very simple. If Vipul and if all of you are self-aware about yourself at few levels, which I'll come to little later, but for now, just leaving you with a thought. If Vipul and all of you are self-aware about yourself, what do you think, or how do you think self-awareness is going to help you in influencing this scenario? Think about it. So, any answers? If I'm self-aware about this person who has that potential to put me off, who uses those expressions which can really, either implicitly or explicitly, but they can put me off together, altogether, my self-awareness will help me here. And my self-awareness about myself in this scenario is, I am better off when I do not answer back. I am better off when I do not answer back, rather than when I answer back and have that palpitation, oh, now what is going to happen? Some skirmish, is it going to enter my life? So I am more aware, I'm aware that I am more resourceful, underlining word was more, I am more resourceful when I do not reply back to that person who is putting me off, because that is giving me a sense of authority, a sense of one rank up, that, hey, I have that baton to either reply back or not reply back. And that is where, despite being I'm put off, I am yet at peace. How interesting is that? Though I'm put off, yet I am at peace. And it is me who has that anchor. कि भैया अब तो मेरी मर्जी है, मैंने जवाब दे दिया तो दे दिया, नहीं दिया तो नहीं दिया, ये तो मेरा इस वक्त ओहदा है, मेरी अथॉरिटी है, सामने वाले ने तो लूज कर दिया. एंड इफ आई वॉज नॉट सेल्फ अवेयर, अ रिफ्लेक्स एक्शन, बिकॉज आई यूज द वर्ड पुट ऑफ, सो द पर्सन has put me off and I was not self-aware, I reply back and then my heart is palpitating, I am not feeling very comfortable, and I do not even know that how did I end up in this scenario. Ki bhaiya maine to jawab de bhi diya, uske baad bhi mujhe wo shanti nahi mil rahi, and I do not even know. If you all are with me, give me a thumbs up so I know that you are in the moment and you are trying to be self-aware. Vipul bechare ke upar to ye zimmedari hai self-aware hone ki. So he is the one who is giving that thumbs up. But I'll encourage as many of you, if you are there in the moment, if you are able to connect this concept of self-awareness and the depth of this concept. So self-awareness ka sirf matlab ye nahi hai ki main kaun hoon, mujhe pata hai, ya mujhe kya acha lagta hai, kya bura lagta hai, mujhe pata hai, what is my strength, what is my weakness, mujhe pata hai. Self-awareness is a little deeper if I want to use it to influence somebody. So moving ahead. And Vipul, just in case if any question comes up in the chat box and you find it useful enough, do stop me there. I'll be more than happy to take it.
So for sure,
thank you. So in the first and second statement, I did not use anything like a right or a wrong, because there is nothing right, nothing wrong in your awareness. Right or wrong will actually lie in what your awareness does for you and lets you do. I repeat myself only to make things right in front of you as a visual flash. Number one, I said, what comes to your mind when you see this picture? I received beautiful answers saying self-confidence, motivation, et cetera, resourceful. And I said, yes, most of the time, first thing will come to me and it is effective that I'm powerful, I'm resourceful, only if I truly can do what I am thinking, what I'm feeling. If it is the other way around, that is, if it is ineffective, then it's a myth because I have not been able to. Is there anything right and wrong in my awareness? No. Where is right or wrong lying? Right or wrong lies in my what my awareness does for me. So when I was aware for point one that I'm all powerful, but I actually did not behave accordingly. My actions were not in alignment. So my awareness did not do right for me. However, if I was aware that, okay, I have resources, but not up to the mark, so I should have that buffer of caution. So then my awareness did exactly what it should have done for me, making it effective, making it more influential. On this note, let me share an experience around this concept, which I have just had yesterday. Excuse me. And the experience was beautiful, actually. And so the experience went like, yesterday late evening, I had an interaction with a big fish in coaching and business industry. And that was around, and that interaction was around business coaching. So I was aware that I have not done enough business coaching because I'm more on the emotional side. I'm more on the performance side, but not as a business. That was my first awareness. Was this making me a little weak around interacting with this big fish? Yes, a little. I accepted that. I was in my awareness zone. And since I also had another awareness of myself, that no matter if I've not done enough business coaching, but I know the skill to coach. I know the skills to ask right questions. And third part of my awareness was, since the other person knows more about his requirement, so I should be open to accept my limitation. These were three paramount points of awareness that I had yesterday while interacting with the person. Interaction had its own highs and lows, but it never let me go weak because I knew what I know. And I knew this is only what I know. Am I making sense to you? If yes, let me know if you have something on mind. Anyone, anything on mind right now? Anybody, can you see something, Vipul, in the chat box?
No, I can't see anything. However, I would encourage everyone, you know, to put forward whatever they're thinking. And whatever they're
seeing. Absolutely. Yes, Vipul. Whatever you are thinking now. Agar dimag mein kahin wo gutham gutha bhi ho gaya na, khayalon ka, bhavnaon ka, that's okay. Usko bhi voice out kijiye. Because this curiosity, this confusion, either curiosity or confusion, both of them are precursor to learning. Learning what? Learning self-awareness. So, aap shayad mere se ye bhi pooch sakte hain that Anju, are you trying to tell me that at this age with this kind of an experience, I'm not self-aware? No, I'm not saying this. All I'm saying is that there is always a time, there is always a chance to increase my self-awareness to the deeper and the deepest level in the moment. In the moment. So, as I said, my yesterday's interaction, I could sail through with confidence because I had my self-awareness, the three paramount points of my self-awareness that I knew how much I knew and I accepted that. I did not say, no, I'm very powerful. I know coaching. I can do, you know, coaching is coaching. I can coach anything. No, I did not. And then the third point that I came up with, I was aware that I must be open to what the other person tells me because he knows his requirement more than me. He knows his requirements more than me. So my awareness was not about his awareness, but my own awareness. Having said that, having given you one situation and one event, let me bring your attention to the conceptual clarity here. And conceptual clarity on self-awareness says that it involves being aware. Self-awareness involves being aware of different aspects of the self, including my traits. Do I get angry easily? Is my trait to trust people easily? Or is my trait to be skeptical a little? Is my behavior to get angry easily? Is my behavior to drag anything? What is my behavior and how do I feel about things? Do I feel weak? Do I feel amazed? Do I feel astonished? Do I feel rejected? What is it about the situation I am entering or about the stimuli where I am surrounded? So for example, after these one and a half years of pandemic that we have spent now. So just a few days back, I asked my son, he's 14 years of age. And I said, Jay, don't you miss going out to parties and going to that school and stuff? And his self-awareness was, Mommy, I do miss. I do feel a little, low at times that, oh, I'm not able to interact with people at all. But I also know that I can keep myself busy and I'm okay with it. Yeah. So was his self-awareness about himself on a higher side? Yes or a no? Yes or a no? Okay. So I see very much. Thank you, Anita ji. And since his self-awareness was high, his response came to me as a beautiful surprise that coming up from a 14 years of age, 14 years of a boy, and this candid answer, it actually influenced me. How? It influenced me that, hey Anju, tu kitni pagal hai. I mean, so many things you already have to do and still you keep cribbing ki are bahar nahi ja pate, are ye nahi hota. So unknowingly he influenced me. Because his self-awareness was high. But however, if he was knowing that he had to influence me through the answer that he had to give me, how comfortably he would have influenced me. Yes or a no? Yes or a no? Okay. Seeing the chat box? Yes, yes, yes. Okay. Thank you so much. Moving ahead. Self-awareness is essentially a psychological state in which oneself becomes the focus of attention because it is self. I have to be aware of myself. Again, giving you an example. While we were just setting up all this, while we were setting up for this session, so Shalini, a volunteer, a person working with IABP, she was there to check things with me. And I asked, she asked me a question that, I asked her a question that if everything is okay, because I was somewhere down the line self-aware that there can be a trouble with my voice. And she said that your voice is echoing. And because I was self-aware, I said, is it echoing or is there some kind of a fuzziness in the voice because of the wind? And she said, yes, it is fuzziness because of the wind. I could influence the scenario then and there instead of searching for various options. Ki kya problem hai? Mic mein koi dikkat to nahi hai? System to theek kaam kar raha hai? Koi aur dusra device to wahan pada nahi hua? Echo kaise ho raha hai? Because I was self-aware, I could influence that scenario. And we could come to the solution very, very quickly. And third part is, self-awareness is how an individual consciously knows and understands their own character, strengths, feelings, motives, and desires. So while I got connected for this particular scenario, I was amazed with Vipul's self-awareness, wherein he said that generally, and his self-awareness was to the level that he he has not put it forward to me. So now he should put this fact forward to me that generally they start at such and such point of time. However, in case this number of strength is not reached by, let's say, 3-5, 3-7, then they might do yet another conversation, and then they will bring me then they'll open the session for me. And now then my self-awareness to influence him came in picture, and I said, fine Vipul, no problem, even if we start at 3:30, I am aware that I have a hard stop at 4:05 and I will have to stop myself there, so please give me a bell. How do you think are we progressing in the direction of self-awareness being a primer to influence? Any comments, anything that you would want to say? So somebody was trying these annotations on the screen perhaps, and that is how this red line has come up. Interesting. Any thoughts, anyone, before I proceed further? Any thoughts coming to you? Anything that you would want to say before I proceed further? All right. That gives me an opportunity to be aware that, yes, time for me to proceed further. We have four levels of self-awareness. Physical, that is bodily self-awareness. Aaj mera sar dard ho raha hai, ya are aaj to mera dil bag bag ho raha hai, or maybe I have butterflies in the stomach, my neck is getting stiff, whatever. Then mental, I am strong about the situation. Although I am passing through ABC emotion, but I am strong enough, I am prepared enough to get through. That's mental self-awareness. And then when it comes to emotional, there is a wide array of emotions. Am I feeling angry, or am I feeling raged? Am I feeling just a little irritated? What is it that I'm feeling? That becomes my emotional level of self-awareness. Fourth level, that is spiritual, I have marked it in red because I am aware that I have not yet reached this kind of awareness for myself. So I have no right to talk to you about this kind of an awareness. So spiritual self-awareness, I'm sure there are many people right here in the session who can talk about it in terms of awareness. So anyone who would like to unmute and share what can be spiritual awareness, spiritual self-awareness, anyone? Because I am aware, I'm socially aware that there are people. So is there anyone who would like to unmute and talk about it? That's okay. Moving ahead. So as we have just reached a point that self-awareness sirf ek is level pe kaam nahi karti hai ki haan mujhe apne bare mein pata hai, mujhe apni hobbies pata hai, main apna pura din kaise spend karta hu ya karti hu mujhe pata hai, mujhe kya pasand hai kya nahi pasand hai ye mujhe pata hai, that is not enough a self-awareness to be able to influence somebody. The amount of self-awareness which will have to come minimum at three levels to influence somebody is the physical, the mental, the emotional. Physical self-awareness can be when you're talking to somebody who you have to influence and you yourself are jittery but you do not know, then your physical self-awareness is low. However, if your emotional self-awareness is high, that yes, I am feeling anxious, this emotional self-awareness can let you influence your own physical posture to be able to influence the other person. So what are all these levels of self-awareness doing to me or to you? They are giving me the opportunity to improve myself. Second, they are giving me the opportunity to influence others, because that's what we started off with. Self-awareness, that's the primer, that's the coating, that is the shield which will not let you stop yourself from influencing others. So if you have the coating of self-awareness at minimum three levels, physical, mental, emotional, you are at a brighter side to influence the other person. However, the word of caution is your self-awareness at all the minimum three levels, physical, mental, emotional, should be as realistic as possible. So do not hesitate in asking questions to yourself. Am I really as much prepared as I think myself to be? So जब बच्चा कहता है ना, आता है आपके पास और कहता है हाँ मेरा तो ये चैप्टर प्रिपेयर्ड है, आप कहते हो अच्छा ठीक है दे जरा मैं पूछता हूँ या मैं पूछती हूँ, फिर आप खोद खोद के कहीं से कोई एक ऐसा कॉन्सेप्ट निकालते हो और पूछते हो बच्चे से बता इसका क्या मतलब है, how is let's say water H2O and why is it not O2H? अब बच्चे का जो सेल्फ अवेयरनेस था अबाउट द चैप्टर वो था कि उसने तो भाई क्वेश्चन आंसर्स पीछे से पूरे रट लिए हैं और ही इज गुड फॉर अटेम्प्टिंग एनी टेस्ट. बट व्हेन यू चैलेंज हिज सेल्फ अवेयरनेस, सो व्हाट शुड ही हैव बीन अवेयर ऑफ? ही शुड ऑल्सो हैव बीन अवेयर ऑफ द फोर्थ थिंग, दैट इज द एनवायरमेंट. क्या मैं किसी कॉम्पिटिटिव एनवायरमेंट में जा रहा हूँ या इज इट ओनली अ फ्रेंडली मैच? तो भाई अगर तो मेरे को कोई आकाश का या कोई आईआईटी का कोई डीसी का एग्जाम क्लियर करना है, सो आई माय सेल्फ अवेयरनेस अबाउट माय प्रिपरेशन शुड बी कि क्या मेरा एटॉमिक लेवल तक प्रिपरेशन है, और अगर स्कूल लेवल के लिए प्रिपेयर किया है तो ठीक है, जितना क्लास में कराया गया है, जितना नोट्स आए हैं, जितना क्वेश्चन आंसर्स है, जितना मेरी रेफरेंस बुक में है, दैट मच इज डन, आई एम ग्रेट. Thank you for that yawn. That's very, very interesting. Are you aware of yourself that whether are you feeling a little bored or a little tired or is it a little monotony? I feel the smile on the person's face, though I can't see his or her face, but I feel the smile on the face moving ahead.
Ma'am, I have a question.
Yes, please.
Ma'am, what is the difference between knowing something and being aware of something?
Okay, so I know that I get angry, all right? However, being aware demands you to know that is that trigger reaching you that you are about to get angry? Or has that trigger already reached you? So I know, but am I aware? Does that answer your question, Shalini?
Yeah, so we can say that the knowing thing is more experiential.
More evidence-based. However, when you say awareness, it is right there in the moment. Although again, it is experiential, again, it is evidence-based, but अवेयरनेस इज देयर इन द मोमेंट, दैट इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. मैं अपने बारे में इन जनरल अवेयर हूं, लेकिन ये कैसे हुआ कि मेरे एक बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट डील मेरे हाथ से चली गई क्योंकि मैं सामने वाले को इन्फ्लुएंस ही नहीं कर पाई. क्यों नहीं इन्फ्लुएंस कर पाई? क्योंकि उस मोमेंट में मेरी सेल्फ अवेयरनेस ड्रॉप हो गई. क्या सेल्फ अवेयरनेस ड्रॉप हो गई? दैट I am not in my control today because somebody in my family is suffering from a grave disease and news may come at any point of time. Yeah, so I was knowing that I am sad, but I was not aware there in the moment. Both of them are experiential, both of them are evidence based. The frame, knowing frame is a continuous frame. Awareness frame, the perspective that I'm trying to bring here is right there in the moment. Does that bring more clarity?
Yeah.
Okay, great. Moving ahead. Can any one of you recall any of your interview in the life, maybe for a job, for marriage?
Ma'am.
Yes, Vipul.
Ma'am, can we take one more question? Anita.
Yes, please. Yes, Anita ji. Yes. What is that question?
Thank you. Basically, this was pertaining to the previous slide. You mentioned spirituality or all four mm-hmm. as leading to improving oneself and influencing others.
That's right. So these are four levels of self-awareness. And I said that please excuse me because I myself have no idea of the spiritual self-awareness about myself. So I have no right to talk about it. And that's why it is in red. However, the literature says self-awareness need to be at four levels to give you that opportunity to improve yourself and influence the other person. Is there a question, Anita?
Well, I am still not very clear on how spirituality or the spiritual self-awareness is an opportunity to improve self and others, but I'll let it pass. I mean, I'll
Okay. I'll allow me in that case. I'll try my best to answer. So let's say I am a person who is, I'm a person who is high on spirituality, and I am aware of this, that I am high on spirituality. Now I'm entering a party wherein there is going to be a lot of hoo-halla, and people are going to, people will play pranks, people will have fun in their own ways. But since I am high on spirituality, I am very calm, let's say, and I am a person who is entering that party only to oblige my friend, maybe, who has invited me, or my heart is basically not lying there. However, I'm entering that party because my friends very, very politely, very, very humbly invited me there. If I am aware of my spiritual quotient there, then I will ensure that I try to be one of the thread in the fabric of that party. But if I am not, it may happen that with my behavior of maybe being quiet, or with my behavior of talking too much about what I want to talk about, may make other people feel a little detached from me. So I lose my influence there on them. Does that give you a pathway to think? I'm sure there is a Pandora to think around it. But does that give you a pathway to think, Anita?
Yes, actually, in a way. But again, the question does remain spiritual. The term, does it equal to mindfulness here?
Okay. So when you are aware right there in the moment. So no, I'm not only referring to being mindful, I am referring to a broader aspect here. And as I already expressed my inability, because I said I am myself not a very spiritually aware, I'm not a spiritual person, so what to talk about being aware in the spirituality. But yes, mindfulness, Anita, will come when you are being aware of yourself right there in the moment. So mindfulness will cover all possible awareness. Now, does that give you a better perspective?
It does, yes.
Okay, thank you.
Yes, yes.
Thank you. Moving ahead. Rashmi. Yes, please.
Ma'am, Rashmi again.
Hi, Rashmi. Here. Yes, Dr. Rashmi.
I guess, can I answer this question a bit?
Why not? Why not?
I do not assure whether my answer will be perfect or not, but what my understanding says is, as the term says, the spiritual, and it entails the term spirit. And we have always talked about mind, body, and spirit. Now, the first three levels of self-awareness, which talks about physical, that is the body, mental, that talks about the mind part, and of course, the emotional, which talks about emotions. All three, we all know, अगर हम स्पिरिचुअल अध्यात्म के टर्म्स में बात करें, आत्मा के टर्म्स में बात करें, तो हमारा एक शरीर है, हमारा मन है और हमारी आत्मा है. हम शारीरिक रूप से, जैसा आपने कहा, that we become self-aware of our body. Am I feeling tired? Am I feeling, lethargic? I am having pain in my any part of the body. That is being physically self-aware. And similarly, mental self-awareness will entail, as you said, ma'am, like mind. At mind level, मन के level पर हम क्या महसूस कर रहे हैं, and similarly at emotional level. But when it comes to spiritual self-awareness, it goes beyond all three levels, and it means knowing your soul basically. हम आत्मा से जब जुड़ते हैं, और तभी कहा जाता है कि योग, प्राणायाम, ध्यान और mindfulness, of course. Mindfulness is the basic step which helps you to connect to your soul. And that helps you in real self-awareness, to come connect with your real self. I will not take much time in this, so I will try my best to very sankhep mein aap logon ko batane ki koshish kari. I don't know, I am right or wrong. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Rashmi, for being that sporty and for coming up and sharing your perspective on this. Thank you so much. So, Anita ji, does that give you some more thought, some more food for thought to ponder?
Yes,
Yes, yes, very much, very much. Thank
fantastic,
you.
Fantastic, fantastic. And that's you. The and that's the beauty of co-learning. जैसे जैसे कि जब शुरुआत में बात हुई थी तभी बात की कि I am also a learner and हम यहाँ पर co-learning करेंगे तो बहुत ही मजा आएगा, बहुत ही खूबसूरत सफर रहेगा. It is 3:45 and yes, I am mindful of the time. Moving to the next question that I raised. And the question was, क्या आप में से कोई याद कर पा रहा है अपना जॉब इंटरव्यू, अपना मैरिज इंटरव्यू, कोई प्रमोशनल इंटरव्यू, कोई भी किसी भी तरीके का इंटरव्यू? Anyone who would like to think about and चलो, let's do it this way that all of you in your own space, all of you in your own space, think of
इसका अभी था, कितने बजे था इसका?
I'll request you to go on mute. Vipul, please put people on mute. Are you there, Vipul?
Yeah.
Thank you. Please do the needful. Please do the needful. Yeah. Mute all participants and then just unmute me. That will be great. Okay.
Yeah, I think there was one participant I have muted him.
No problem. Now thank you. Thank you. It keeps happening. Technology, so it keeps happening. That's all right. Yes, in your own space, think of any interview, be it job, marriage, promotion, any other interview. So while you appeared for that interview, which means questions were asked and you answered, there might have been a few questions which you were not even prepared for, but aapke dimag ko sochna pada uska jawab dene ke liye, jawab nikla ya nahi bhi nikla. Mera sawal hai, us interview ke baad aapko kya mila? पहली चीज, the first thing, I'm not talking of the offer letter only to give you a cue. I'm not talking of your spouse. I'm not talking of that increment letter. What is that first thing that you received after appearing for an interview? Anyone?
Ma'am, satisfaction or dissatisfaction?
Okay, satisfaction or dissatisfaction, of course.
Awareness about what I know and what I don't know.
Awesome, Nitya. So you see, both of these are awareness, but at different level. So satisfaction, dissatisfaction about is more about emotional thing, whether I was satisfied or not. And then you said how much do I know about myself? So that was on the holistic part. And then experiences, Nayan, what Nayan is saying, all in all, what was received by us after any of such interview was feedback. And this feedback actually gave more awareness to me about myself, right or wrong? Now, this more awareness could be वो अवेयरनेस थी ही नहीं मेरे पास, या जो अवेयरनेस इंटेंसिटी 1 पे थी अब वो इंटेंसिटी 2 या 3 पे हो गई क्योंकि वो मुझे रीअश्योरेंस मिल गया. कई बार हमारे स्कूल टाइम में याद कीजिए, इफ यू कैन गो बैक टू दैट स्कूल टाइम, जब हम कोई चीज में पार्टिसिपेट करते थे विद अ बिलीफ या विद एन अवेयरनेस दैट हाँ आई कैन डू इट, और फिर टीचर कहती थी बहुत ही बढ़िया तरीके से आपने न्यूज पढ़ा या बहुत ही बढ़िया तरीके से आपने डिबेट में पार्टिसिपेट किया. सो दैट एक्चुअली गेव हायर एश्योरेंस, दैट एक्चुअली इंक्रीज्ड माय लेवल ऑफ सेल्फ अवेयरनेस. And yes, after any of the interview, what I receive is feedback, and that gives me awareness on different levels as we discussed. Any questions so far? Because I have a question. So now my question is, if I really want to be self-aware and I want to use that as a primer to influence people, influence situation, influence myself, do I have the intention and willingness to actually use that feedback in future, or do I become defensive and I say, nahi, it is not possible, aisa to ho hi nahi sakta. So I will keep these answers, your individual answers. I will request you to hold on to yourself. क्योंकि अगर मैंने अपने फीडबैक को यूटिलाइज नहीं किया, उसको वैलिडेट नहीं किया, उसको अपने आप को इम्प्रूव करने के लिए यूज नहीं किया, इट मींस दैट आई एम नॉट हैविंग एनी इंटेंशन टू रेज माय सेल्फ अवेयरनेस. एंड इफ दैट इज द केस, my primer to influence anyone else is on the lower side. So winding up everything, coming to influence, that if self-awareness is about knowing about your character, trait, behavior, it is a psychological state, it is also a conscious choice, then what is influence? Influence is exactly the result of the input coming from self-awareness, because influence is your capacity to have an effect on the character, the development part of the scenario, behavior of someone or something, or the effect itself. My ask now is I give you three major things in this discussion. First is the title, of course, self-awareness, a primer to influence. Then second, we talked about self-awareness. And third, I stopped at what influence is. So if you have to give, one line around your learning so far, or maybe a set of 2-3 words, what will those 2-3 words or a line be? And I strongly insist each one of you to pen down your thoughts so that your self-awareness is increased, is raised. Any 3-4 words, any statement that you would want to share? Anyone? Okay. All right. Ajay ji says eye-opener in terms of what self-awareness, and thank you so much, Ajay ji. Coming this thing, if it is coming from a veteran like you, I think I have been able to reach or at least touch the goal that I was here for. Nitya says influence is the direct outcome of, absolutely. Influence is the direct outcome. Now the working should be on self-awareness. How many times at deeper level am I able to keep myself self-aware? And before I wind up, I have taken permission of a friend of mine who is working with SBI cards at a very, very senior level. And just a few days back when we were having a chit chat around AI, he shared a message, and with his permission, I am reading it out verbatim here, that what is his take on self-awareness, because of late, in fact, recently only he has stepped into the journey of emotional intelligence. So his verbatim message was, and I did not find anything more beautiful to end the session. So his verbatim message was, Anju, I had this very emotionally tearing moment at office. One, which brings out the devil in you. Yes, the Saturn. And I was like, no. Watch yourself. This will pass. Let this pass. And I was so happy that I took a moment to let this pass. Though it wasn't easy to subdue the Saturn, but I still could do it. And that changed the outcome of scenario. On this note, friends, I'll take a bow from my side. I have touched upon what I wanted to touch upon. If you have questions, feel free to ask. If you have something to share from your life experience, please, we still have 6 minutes to go because I am a time stickler. So anything, floor is yours. It is open. Vipul, over to you.
Okay. Thank you so much, ma'am. Fantastic energy. Definitely the connection between the self-awareness and the influence is something that I personally learned. However, I will keep the things short, and I would request, before we move forward to the questions, I would request everyone to just turn on their cameras so that we can, have a snapshot of all the participants. On top of that, how you felt about the session, you can, just share, whatever emoticons you have. Just share about how you felt about the session, and I will take a screenshot. I'm still seeing few people have not turned on their cameras. If they can, that's fine. Yeah, good to see faces now. That's fantastic. All right. Okay. Let me take. Okay. All right. Thank you for posing and thank you for your patience. We definitely can move forward to the questions. However, I would request everyone, if anyone who wishes to see the session again, we'll be posting it on YouTube on the channel of Indian School of Business Psychology. So you can see it there. And if you're interested to learn more about those, you can always connect to IIBP and we'll be pleasure, we'll be honored to, you know, have more such experienced speakers speaking on various different topics. And if you really love this session, do feel free to share on LinkedIn. And so that, you know, whatever work IIBP, my team is doing, we will get a, you know, huge boost for whatever work we are doing, we are whatever volunteering we are showing. It's great that once we get responses, we really, I, my team in Ministry of Business Psychology feels good about it, and we are motivated to have more such sessions. Okay, I will not take much time. So anyone who has any questions, they can ask. Subhash has some question, I guess. He has raised his hand. So Subhash, you can unmute yourself and you can ask any question. Subhash, are you with us? Okay. So we don't have any questions as of now, but I have a question.
Yes,
so
please.
In the meanwhile, so as you have set the stage when you were asking everyone to, you know, you whatever you feel or whatever you thought or whatever you're thinking, just feel free to share. So I think somewhere in the middle of the session, I was thinking about this issue that age group from 18 to 24, which includes me, is facing, which is called wishful thinking. And my question is related to counter wishful thinking and denial about self-awareness.
Okay.
Sometimes teenagers or, you know, young professionals do fall into wishful thinking, and there is this sense of denial about self-awareness, okay, which is causing a lot of issues. So I would, you know, would like to learn about how one could you know, counter wishful thinking and develop more awareness about self-awareness rather than denial on the awareness front. Did I present my question clearly?
Yes,
or?
Yes, you did, Vipul. In fact, reading your neuro-linguistic pattern, I would love to understand from you, or rather, I would like to congratulate you on one thing, that since you have pinpointed, okay, because there is wishful thinking and because I want to increase my self-awareness, so how do I do it? Because you have an intention, Vipul. I'm sure all you need is all you or anyone who is in that space needs just a professional help from outside, because you already have that intent. If there is no intent, if there is no you know, realization that I am doing wishful thinking, then that's the trouble. That is where trouble lies. But you already are in a space where you are aware of it. So congratulations. Mm-hmm. All you need is a support from outside.
All right. Thank you, Anju, for answering that question.
Dr. Anju,
Anju, yeah. I'm back.
Yes.
Am I audible?
Absolutely, Subhash sir. You are very much audible. Kapoor sir is very much audible.
And in fact, I was very late. I had a session, but since I had committed, I will join. Though I've joined at the fag end, but I have one thing to share. And let it be responded by the participant also. I think the concept of self-awareness has got something to do with the upbringing of a child right from childhood. More often than not, child is aware, but he pretends. And it is the parent who don't pinpoint. That is one aspect. If we start taking care on that aspect, I think they will grow up as adults who are really self-aware what I am. Am I really what I mean to say? Am I really reflected what the people feel about me? What do you say about it?
All right. Kapoor sir, indeed, as usual, it is you know, coming from a seasoned professional like you with so much of experience of handling I don't know how many headcounts, certainly I would totally agree to you that it is primary responsibility of a parent. However, now when we are talking of self-awareness at this point of time, my endeavor, my focus is you have already taken the responsibility to be aware, and now you should be in the space of rather honoring that, yes, if I am aware, if I am, now I'm not talking about the glitches that happened, I'm not talking about anyone else who is responsible to increase my self-awareness. I am responsible for my actions. That is the level of self-awareness, or that is the space of self-awareness I am trying to touch base upon. However, what you said cannot be denied at all, because what I am today is the mix and match of my upbringing and where I was, the DNA that I was born with, and the nurturing that I have been given with, undoubtedly. But now is the time that I must take responsibility of increasing my awareness. If I was pretentious, let me take the responsibility that now is the time not to be pretentious. So yes, somebody asked a question in the chat box also, Raghavan ji, that the quote you gave of self-awareness isn't more of self-management. Self-management is the result of self-awareness. Management, yes, without awareness is not possible. So awareness will lead to management, and that is how it becomes primer to influence.
I think the befitting tribute to one of my most dedicated, enlightened, and focused mentee, Dr. Anju Chawla, I'll give by a quote. Feedback is the breakfast of champion. Those who respond on the feedback become the ultimate winner. Just know where you are, what you are, why you are. Ideal example is Sachin Tendulkar.
Fantastic, sir. Thank you so much for adding that. Thank you. And it certainly is a pride moment for me to have my mentor here. Subhash Kapoor ji is my mentor from my college, and that's indeed a pride moment for me. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Anju madam, can I ask one question?
Shrikant ji, of course.
Yeah, do we have time for that, no? Yeah.
Yes, we have another 3 minutes. Yes, sir. Four, okay, five, I have a hard stop. Yes, Shrikanji.
Yeah, these days I listen to a lot of the webinars, or this one, videos and audios on emotional intelligence. But it has become a practice that many a times mindfulness and self-awareness, they are used interchangeably,
right?
as much as I know, mindfulness is something you are aware of the surroundings, okay, and self-awareness is something which you go inside, okay, and so like you are aware of your emotions, you are aware of your thoughts. Okay, and as you correctly said, the last 1 hour, how much you can influence others, okay, by virtue of your emotions, everything. So, is there any difference between the two, or it can be used interchangeably?
Sir, here my take would be that mindfulness will increase the horizon of my awareness. Picking up the line from you only. So for me, these are not two separate things. I would say if I am practicing mindfulness, my horizon of awareness will increase. I hope that will serve some purpose this meaningful question.
Right. I got it.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you. Pleasure.
Okay, ma'am.
Yes, Vipul.
thank you, everyone, for asking questions. As we are on time, we have a hard stop at 4:05. So if you have any questions, you know, you can put in the chat box. I'll be there to, you know, take all the questions, and then we can, you know, post it on the IIPP LinkedIn page, all the answers related to the questions. However, for today, a sincere thanks, first of all, to Dr. Anju Chawla. to IIBP and my supporting team, and to all the participants who patiently, interacting through the entire session, and to learn and engage in more such events. Please connect with IIBP and related endeavors by following us, and it would be a pleasure to come up with more such enriching sessions. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you so much. Thank you, everyone, for attending. Bye bye.
Thank you.
Bye. Thank you.
Bye.
Bye.